Danny Welbeck showed boss Arsene Wenger yet again he is not a spent force.He scored twice and made another, as Arsenal erased the memory of their 4-0 drubbing at Liverpool before the international break. The critics were demanding Arsenal boss Wenger walk the plank after stormy start to the season. Then they witnessed the team sheet, cue more howls. Alexis Sanchez, Olivier Giroud and Theo Walcott were all left on the bench yesterday. But under fire Wenger, as he has done so often in the past, bounced back again to show why he is the boss. Love him or hate him, it's why the Frenchman truly is Arsenal's Marmite man. Two goals in the first 27 minutes shows that the Frenchman had called it right. I am delighted today. You want your side to perform and we did. He had Welbeck at his best. Scoring one, making another. And new pint-sized striker Alexandre Lacazette adding another to sweep Bournemouth off their feet in a blistering first half. And there was again another fine cameo show from Sead Kolasinac, a muscular Bosnian who arrived from Schalke virtual unknown. These must be worrying times for Bournemouth, who have now lost their first four games. Manager Eddie Howe has now become a manager under pressure, possibly even more so than Frank de Boer at Palace and Slaven Bilic at West Ham. Howe blasted his side on a day Wenger began planning the future without Sanchez, who refused to sign a new deal in the summer and is still high on Manchester City's wanted list. Sanchez came off the bench late on and was booed by Arsenal fans, angry he has made it known he wants to leave the club. Wenger said, I have a selection problem and I can't play them all. Danny is a class act. Of the booing of Alexis, he now has to respond to them. The Gunners boss indicated he is ready to snub Sanchez again by recalling Jack Wilshere for Thursday night's Europa League game against Cologne. He said, he is a possibility. Wenger added, I am delighted today. You want your side to perform and we did. It is important you play for your club. I thought Welbeck was superb. The coaches here love him because of what he is doing and trying to achieve and you can't get higher praise than that. The Cherries are a side you like to watch, but they rarely thrill. They looked good going forward, mixing it well in midfield but relying more on the mistakes of opposing defenders rather than creating chances for themselves. This is going to be a tough winter for them. Wenger used his program notes to admit he made mistakes over events in the last few weeks, where transfers, in and out of the club, had gone wrong. But he also used them as a personal love letter to his team, saying sport is sport and I must say I love my players, I believe in my players and we have a good opportunity to show we have the quality that people want from us. Not quite Romeo and Juliet, but as love and score work. Arsenal were as ruthless as Bournemouth were ineffectual. They are a side in free fall. The spotlight in the build-up to this weekend has been on De Boer at Palace and Hammers boss Bilic because they had lost their three opening games. Bournemouth had sneaked under the radar, but they had also failed in their opening matches. Being outside of London does have its advantages. Like both Palace and West Ham, Howe has spent big on players.Bournemouth went into the game having not beaten Arsenal in any competition where they have crossed swords, the nearest they have come to success being last season, when they let a 3-goal lead slip to draw 3-3 at the Vitality Stadium. Yesterday, Arsenal took the lead in the 6th minute when Aaron Ramsey, seizing onto Iron Man defender Kolasinac's pass, crossed and Welbeck turned in via his shoulder and ear. Six minutes later, Granit Xhaka had Begovic palming out a 25-yard stinger as Arsenal relentlessly surged forward from all positions. Then Begovic provided similar heroics 5 minutes later, diving to his right to keep out Mesut Ozil's crafted free kick from 20 yards. But Arsenal were not to be denied. Welbeck again was involved when he supplied Lacazette with a perfect pass for the French striker to fire home from 20 yards as their second goal arrived in the 27th minute. Then a minute after Cherry striker Jermain Defoe